Johnstown Food Bank was forced to shut down after fire damaged its storage facilities and possibly contaminated the food inside. KIRO 7 South Sound reporter Kevin McCarty is live now in Spanaway. Kevin, this appears to have been caused by a heating system.
And these are the units that were affected. These are the buildings where they stored the food. You can see they've been boarded up. Right up there, have a look. You can see that heating unit. That's where the fire started. You can see the scorch marks around it. Apparently kicked on last night when the temperatures were really cold. People who depend on this food bank say it makes tough situations even tougher.
Yeah, it's kind of bad.
Stephanie Dumbledon showed up around noon, hoping to get food from the Spanaway Food Bank, only to find it closed.
They're just nice people here.
Yeah.
And they don't make you feel, you know, like you're begging for something or anything.
The early morning fire left a small portion of the food bank's supply buildings charred, but forced the shutdown of daily food giveaways. Everything inside now has to be examined by health inspectors to make sure it's safe to eat.
A lot of food prepped, ready to go for today's distribution. We don't know the loss yet on the food. There's going to be a lot of loss.
Several local churches contribute to the food bank located at Spanaway Lutheran Church. It serves 1,100 people, distributing about 250,000 pounds of food every year. Losing the facility and possibly much of the food inside is having a big impact on the local community.
You have a good day.
There'll be a real dent in the feeding the hungry in this community when this food bank is non-operational.
That concern was echoed by people showing up hoping to take food home to their families.
This is, not going to lie, it's a low-income neighborhood, so we depend on places like this to help sustain and support our families. So.
Well, the Spanaway Food Bank is giving people some options. They have posted these signs here at the food bank, letting them know it's temporarily closed and that they can call the emergency food network if they need assistance. But several churches contribute to this. There was a lot of food inside there, so a lot of people depended on it. And at this point, they don't know when this food bank is going to reopen or how much food has been lost. Live in Spanaway, Kevin McCarty, KIRO 7 News.